The following is a Glass City Communications production.
Last time on Star Trek Valkyrie.
This Board of Inquiry is now in session. Captain Stanfield, this board is here to determine the circumstances related to the loss of all but three of the crew of the USS Valkyrie and the loss of the vessel itself. Also to be determined is whether the commander of the vessel was in any way negligent in the loss should be recommended for court-martial proceedings. Do you understand the purpose of this hearing, Captain, and that any and all testimony you give here today is under oath?
I do, sir.
Yes, sir. It all started around Stardate 9785.3. The Valkyrie's been doing a deep space survey when orders came in diverting us to Starbase 44. There, we picked up the supplies that were needed for medical relief on Paramore. When we arrived, an ion storm was raging in the system, so I ordered that all supplies be transported down on shuttles. The governor contacted me, and I began talking.
If you could come down as well, we've got a situation that I'm hoping Starfleet can assist us with. I'd really appreciate it, Captain.
We're going to be taking off shortly. We should be okay as long as the storm turbulence doesn't get any worse than Force 9. That'll be too rough for the shuttles to come aboard.
Yes, sir. We'll keep you updated on the storm. Commander Elbrick has been doing some interesting warp calculations that show some promise. He's got a simulation running in the engineering computer core that he wants to show you upon your return as well.
Be careful! All this bouncing around from the storm is taking systems offline. And the computer core near you is running an experimental warp simulation. Don't mess with it. I want it running so we can show the captain.
Valkyrie signaling ready to dock in Bay 7. The doors are open, but the storm is causing them to lose tractor lock sporadically. We may need to abort the landing, Captain.
Read here, sir. We're at Force 9 with a few stronger shock waves coming in. The worst will be over in about 15 minutes, with the storm expected to lessen to Force 5.
Valkyrie reporting another strong wave coming in, sir.
And we contacted Starfleet at that point. The Frankfurt arrived and we searched the entire system. No sign of the ship or any debris anywhere. An examination of the shuttle's sensor log showed some kind of warp overload just as the ship disappeared in a bright flash of light. After the search was concluded, the Okuda and the three of us were ferried back to Earth, and here we are, sirs.
Captain Edward J. Stanfield. It is the finding of this inquiry regarding the loss of the USS Valkyrie, NCC 2590, and the loss of all but yourself and two other crew members, that you are to be found not negligent in the loss. However, due to the unknown reason or reasons, that you be given a non-shipboard assignment while all other avenues of inquiry are ongoing. Further, all other starships currently in service with the same kind of new warp core design be withdrawn from service immediately while the engineering core tries to determine any correlation between ion storms and the cores. Captain, you are to report to the Director of Personnel for your new assignment at the close of this session.
Then, Captain, you're dismissed. This inquiry is closed.
Running wild, sir. Velocity off the scale.
Warning.
Navigational scanners inoperative.
Main sensor's not giving intelligent readings.
Full stop.
Aye, sir. Now reading full stop, sir.
I want a position report now. Someone get that view screen operational. Travis, anything on sensors?
I don't believe this. This can't be right. Travis, are you reading the same thing?
Confirmed. Navigational scanners and main sensors are operable and in sync.
Well...
view screen coming on, Commander.
My God! Sir, we've gone to the barrier. We left the galaxy.
And now, the conclusion.
These are the adventures
of the crew of the
Starship Valkyrie.
In peacetime or wartime,
its mission is the same as all of Starfleet's.
To seek out new life and new civilizations.
To preserve the peace and protect the Federation.
To brave the unknown.
In man's greatest frontier.
Episode 301, The Inquiry Part 2.
Bridge to engineering! Report!
Fox here, Commander. Mr. Elberg has his hands full at the moment. Several systems are offline. We can have a report for you shortly, sir.
Get one together as soon as you can, Lieutenant. We need to know what happened to us as soon as possible and what kind of shape we're in. Bridge out.
All hands, this is the bridge. Damage control parties, begin assessing damage and submitting your reports to the second officer. All stations, emergency condition beta.
Sensor is coming back online now, Commander.
The best I can tell, we're approximately 1,773 light years outside the Galactic Barrier. Assuming we have full warp capability, we're nearly 6 months away at warp 8.
Get nothing but static on all subspace bands, sir.
We need to figure out what happened and how to get back home. Travis, what's your theory?
Only conjecture, sir. But possibly some kind of connection with the last wave of distortion from the ion storm. It hit Force 11. Maybe it caused some kind of overload in the warp systems.
But ships encounter ion storms all the time. Yes, they're dangerous, but they never had this effect before, even at Force 11 or higher.
However, we do have a new kind of warp core developed specifically for the Constellation class. Maybe it has some kind of new reaction in some way. Something not thought of before.
Maybe. I guess we'll have to see what engineering reports.
We need to restart the warp core. Can we restart the warp core now?
Aye, sir. Tests have shown no damage, and we've not found any reason for the overload. Ready at any time, Commander.
Initiate the process. Let's get main power back online.
Aye, sir. Ensign, open deuterium injectors, initiate antimatter regulators.
Aye, sir. Beginning core startup sequence new.
Warp core online and systems holding.
Good work, everyone. Engineering the bridge. The warp core is back online.
Good work, Paul. Are the engines up to a rather long trip?
Aye, sir. We'll run ahead on them. I don't see any problem that we can't handle, sir. Let's get back home.
Sounds good. Bridge out. Mr. Swanson.
Turbolift 12 is jammed.
Plot us the most direct course for Federation space. Shrun, once it's ready, engage at warp 8.
Course is 117 Mark 3, plotted towards Epsilon Indy.
Engaging warp 8.
Sensors show clear. However, long range shows a few rogue solar systems just outside the barrier. 153 days at warp 8.
Maybe we should check them out on our way back. Use that time for exploring and to stock up on raw materials before going through the galactic barrier.
Sick bay to bridge.
Go ahead, Doctor.
Where's the captain? I need to talk to him as soon as possible.
We had our accident before the captain returned to the ship. I'm in command, Doctor.
Well, Commander, I need to talk to you now. Can you come down here, or do you want me to come up there?
Come up here, Doctor. We'll talk in the ready room.
On my way.
You have the conch run.
Aye, sir.
Doctor, what can I do for you?
We've got a situation, Andrew. Possible trouble.
What's wrong, Anne?
Computer, transfer file Ravenwood 32 Gamma to this terminal.
Acknowledged. Transfer complete.
This is a file normally available to the captain and CMO of all Starfleet ships. It has to do with the galactic barrier.
I know the barrier is dangerous, but what would cause a command directive about it?
According to this file, previous vessels that encountered the barrier had individuals that were transformed, let's say, into some kind of super beings, telekinesis and so forth. There are certain signs to look for, but according to this, commanding officers are required to destroy the person before they become a threat to the ship or the galaxy at large. There's an addendum showing previous examples.
My God! If it were that bad! Any signs of the symptoms in the crew?
We're checking the crew now. The directive gives details to look for, but with the captain off the ship, you're now in command and needed to be made aware. Commander, Andrew, we will get through this just like we always have. I've got the medical staff working hard to find any signs of this.
Thanks, Anne. Keep me posted.
Aye, sir.
Miller Deschrun, please meet me in the ready room.
Aye, sir. Yes, Commander?
With the captain gone, and being alone out here, we need to work hard and make some changes. As I'm acting captain, you're now acting first officer. Let's have Michael be acting second officer. We need to find out what happened and how to get back.
Should I call a meeting of the senior officers? Get everyone on the same level, as it were?
Good idea. 1 hour?
Aye, sir.
I will meet you all on the bridge shortly.
Lieutenant Bellamy, address intercraft, please. Bridge to all decks. Meetings of all senior officers in Conference Room 1 in 1 hour. That is all.
All right, everyone. You've just heard our situation and about the command directive. If you have anyone showing any of the signs, you are to inform either the doctor or myself. Immediately. Now, I've decided that until we return, Shrun is the acting first officer and Lieutenant Swanson is acting second officer. Paul, what's the story as far as what happened to us? Any clues yet?
I'm afraid we have, sir. It was our fault. We had a simulation running with one of the formulas we found from Admiral Kemp. It was working extremely well, so I headed up to shore as a captain. Well, then we were hit with the Force 11 shockwave. One of the engineers fell against the panel and initiated the sequence. We jumped to warp, but uncontrolled. We ended up out here. I'm sorry, sir. I'll take full responsibility.
Could that formula be used again to get back to Federation space any faster?
I'm leading a team looking into that currently, Commander. If we can control it, we should be able to.
We should also use this opportunity to study those rogue solar systems while we're out here. They're not on any charts and unexplored.
could be dangerous. We don't know what could have been conceived on this side of the barrier.
So far, none of the crew is showing any signs of trouble. Maybe our newer shields have protected us, but we need to be careful.
Thank you, everyone. Mr. Elbert, Mr. Fox, do everything you can to see about increasing our speed and watch over the engines. We're heading home. The quicker, the better.
Aye, sir.
We're also going to explore those systems as we get close. Travis, can we use probes to give us an idea of what's going on with the planets before we get too close?
Aye, sir. I can configure a few probes to explore the systems, in case of any dangers.
Thank you all. Dismissed. Captain's Log, Stardate 9789.4. Commander Andrew Miller recording. We've been on a return trip to the Milky Way galaxy for 9 days so far. Dr. Ravenwood has concluded that we appear to be out of danger of the barrier's effects. Mr. Elberg and his team are supposed to conclude their findings today on the usefulness of the warp calculations that got us out here in the first place.
Torpedo bay here. Status green. No problems here.
Gentlemen, what brings you to the bridge?
We have the answers to the warp calculations. Stefan, go ahead.
Commander, the only way to control it the way we want is to not use full warp power while using the formulas. That may take a different or faster computer processor than even Valkyrie has. The good news is, using the formula at 65% power will still get us to warp 12. That makes the barrier about 2 months away now, and leaves more power available for shields.
Excellent work, gentlemen. You need to get your findings to Starfleet Command when we get back. May need a whole new warp scale for starships. When can we get started?
We need to temporarily shut down the warp drive. I want to reinforce a few conduits and time to reprogram the warp computer.
Let's get started right away. Shrun, drop to full impulse power. Mr. Fox, Mr. Albert, it's all yours.
Aye, sir.
Aye, Commander.
Flowing to impulse power, sir.
Travis, launch the probes. We're close enough for them to reach into the system.
Probe launch successful. On course for the inner planets.
Readings coming in now. Two gas giants in the outer system, both roughly equal in mass to Neptune. The star is G-type, two inner planets, innermost is barren. Second planet has water and an atmosphere. Reading cities and orbital satellites, Commander.
Can we determine their level of technology? Late 20th century or later?
Mid-21st, from what I can tell, sir. Very confusing readings. Some higher technologies are evident.
Do they have anything we may need for supplies?
Reading deep mineral deposits on the planet and... Sir, the probe is reading a weapons lock. The probe is being targeted.
Get it out of there, Lieutenant!
Too late, sir. The probe's been destroyed. I don't recommend sticking around here any longer.
Helm, get us out of here. Back to our original course to Epsilon Indy. Warp 12. Execute.
Aye, sir. We'll reach the barrier in 16 hours.
Warning. Valkyrie is in close proximity to the galactic barrier. Contact is not recommended. Change course immediately. Warning.
Contact in 10 seconds.
Reading negative mass, energy negative, radiation negative.
Navigational sensors have no readings on it.
Shields on maximum.
Contact. We're through it.
All the readings have emergency condition
three. I'll book the bridge.
Emergency force bridge. In place and
go ahead, Paul.
No damage in engineering. Everything seems to be heading just fine. I believe you could try warp 12.5 if you'd like.
Thanks, Paul. Let's try it. Bridge out. Shrun, you heard the man. Warp 12.5. Lieutenant Bellamy, send a subspace message to Starfleet. Let them know our current situation and copy our logs since the date of the accident. Let them know we're back inside the galactic barrier and on course for Federation space. Give them our current coordinates and that we're proceeding on a heading towards Epsilon ND and request instructions.
Aye, sir.
And so, tactically speaking, Kirk took great chances in beaming down to Organia with Commander Spock. But it all worked out in there.
Starfleet Operations to Captain Stanfield.
Stanfield here, go ahead, Operations.
You are to report to Admiral Sondergaard's office immediately, sir.
I'm currently teaching a class in tactics at the Academy.
The Admiral wants you immediately, sir.
Very well, I'll be at command in a few minutes. Stanfield out. I'm sorry, class, I have to leave now. Commander Rand will continue in my absence. Commander?
We've got news on the Valkyrie. She's on her way to Earth now. She'd be here the day after tomorrow.
Was she adrift not far from Earth? How did she get so close? We were over a week away when the accident occurred.
It's all here on this pad, Captain. And after a meeting with Admiral Douglas and the board, you've been fully exonerated. Nothing was your fault, and the ship will need her captain back. Although you may need a new first officer, he's going to be offered his own command. His actions show he's ready. Must have a good teacher, Edward.
Thank you, Admiral. I don't know what to say other than thank you.
She'll be coming into Earth space dock around 1100 hours, day after tomorrow. She'll get a full diagnostic and you'll be off on your mission again. You've got a good ship and a good crew. They do you proud, Edward.
Thank you, Admiral. They are a good crew and I'm going to make sure they know it, too.
Valkyrie, arriving, Bay 3.
Open the gangway.
Captain, it's good to see you, sir.
Good to see you too, all of you. I know there's several officers waiting to debrief you all. I'll be there too, so let's not keep them waiting. Andrew, I guess congratulations are in order. I heard about them offering you your own command.
Yes, sir. They did. The Iroquois.
Well, congratulations, Captain.
No, sir. They offered. I declined.
Well, why? The Iroquois is a very good ship.
Yes, sir, she is. But it's not a deep space exploration vessel like Valkyrie. If it's all the same to you, sir, I'd like to remain aboard as your first officer.
Permission granted, Commander. And Andrew, thank you.
You're welcome, sir.
I understand the ship will be given a full diagnostic and repaired. In the meantime, you're scheduled for a full debriefing in front of the Admiralty. You ready?
Aye, sir.
Report, please, gentlemen.
Captain, all repairs are complete. Diagnostics show all systems at 100%, engines ready. All four nacelles were replaced due to fractures of the cores from the stresses caused by the energies of the increased speeds. The engineering corps has stated it will require a new alloy of some kind to deal with the stresses and energies involved in the new formula. so it won't likely be used until some new class of ship comes out in the future. But as for us, system checkout as ready, sir.
Thank you, Mr. Fox. Get ready for departure. Commander Miller, is this ship ready? We have a mission to continue. 3 months in space dock is long enough.
Aye, sir. Gina, get permission from the dockmaster to depart. Michael, clear all moorings and umbilicals. Shrun, thrusters at station keeping. Engineering, we're ready to depart. Readiness status?
Last of the crew are aboard. The engineering systems are at full readiness, and Mr. Elberg is awaiting your orders, sir. He reports intimates is set.
Sounds good. Bridge out.
Dockmaster reports clearance given. 30 seconds for gate 4, Captain.
Helm systems ready, sir.
Thrusters ahead. Take us out, Charon.
Orbital departure on clock, sir.
Sensor system ready, sir.
Once clear, set course back to the 4-next cluster. Warp 6.
Aye, sir.
Engage.
You've been listening to Star Trek Valkyrie,
Episode 301, The Inquiry Part 2.
Starring Jerry Stanford as Captain Edward Stanfield, Michael Lieben as Commander Andrew Miller, Toby Kerfman as Lieutenant Commander Shrun, Michael Studeberg as Chief Engineer Paul Elberg, Dean Rogers as Lieutenant Michael Swanson, Jacob Stanford as Lieutenant Travis Reed, Bring Stanford as Lieutenant Gina Bellamy, Alexis Waters as Dr. Anne Ravenwood, John Kwan Yun as Lieutenant Stephen Fox, and Andrea Collenberg as Valkyrie's computer voice. Guest starring Robin Hiert as Admiral Jan Sondergaard, Terry Self as the Ensign in Engineering, Charles Todd Gwynn as the Operations Voice, with Michael Bednar as Governor Bartlett, Brad Hathaway as Captain Jeffrey Pierce, Julia Morizawa as the Lieutenant in the Shuttle, Michael Day as Ensign John Decker, and special guest Doug Drexler as Admiral Alvin Douglas, Starfleet JAG. Background voices by Denis, Roma, Val Kilgallin, Desere Chambers, Renee Stanford, and John Kilgallin. Music by Jerry Goldsmith, Brian Tyler, James Horner, Velton Ray Bunch, Ron Jones, Denis McCarthy, and Jay Chattaway. Original theme music for Valkyrie by Jesse Richardson. Audio play and audio mix for The Inquiry Part 2 by Jerry Stanford. Star Trek Valkyrie is based on Star Trek, created by Gene Roddenberry. Star Trek is a registered trademark of Paramount and CBS, all rights reserved. Star Trek Valkyrie is not affiliated with Paramount, CBS, or any other Star Trek rights holders. No copyright infringement is intended. Star Trek Valkyrie is a production of Glass City Communications. Executive producer is Jerry Stanford. Visual arts director for Valkyrie is Video Space FX. Stay tuned for our next episode, available for free download at StarTrekValkyrie.com and available on YouTube, youtube.com/user/ValkyrieNCC2590. And also look for us on iTunes. Stay tuned for our next episode, The Primal Directive, coming soon.